And we'll review the lineups, the starting lineups for both teams. The Padres tonight will lead off with their second baseman, Tim Flannery. Flannery leads off at second base. Tony Gwynn bats second in right field. Steve Garvey hits third at first. Greg Nettles bats fourth at third base. Terry Kennedy hits fifth behind the plate. Carmelo Martinez in left field batting sixth. Kevin McReynolds, not having a good sophomore year, batting seventh in center field. Gary Templeton having a great year at shortstop, bats eighth, and pitching and batting ninth, the right-hander Eric Schau. Schau, 7-7 on the year with an ERA of 3.42. No record this season against the Braves. Last year he was 2-0 in lifetime. He has a very impressive 6-1 record against Atlanta. Now for the Braves. Claudel Washington leads off in right field. Rafael Ramirez bats second at short. Dale Murphy hits third in center field. And the hot one, Bob Horner, bats fourth at first base. Terry Harper hits fifth in left field. Coming off his hand injury, Ken Obergefell returns to the lineup. He'll bat sixth and play third base. Rick Cerrone behind the plate bats seventh. Glenn Hubbard hits eighth at second base. And pitching and batting ninth will be Rick Mailer. Mailer, the Braves' ace, is 15-8 on the year, an ERA of 3.16. This season, he's 2-0 against San Diego. In lifetime, he is 4-3. San Diego, 53-46. They're in second place, 5 games behind the Dodgers, and 6 back in the loss column. And the Braves in fifth place, 14 games behind L.A., are 43-54. There you see the umpires. Lanny Harris will call the balls and strikes. Tim Flannery leads off of the Padres, and leading off the broadcast, here's Pete.
Thank you, John. Flannery at 272, one homer, 24 RBIs. We're underway. It's nothing at one. He and Jerry Royster platoon at second base with Alan Wiggins, now a member of the Baltimore Orioles. And combined, the two have had a very productive year. It's 0-2. We showed you Flannery's numbers, 272, one homer, 24 RBIs. Royster's hitting 280 with one homer, 17 RBIs. Here's the 0-2 from Mailer. We have seen Rick Mailer pitch, I guess for about 4 years up here now in the big leagues. And this year, more noticeably than ever, he really varies the way he pitches in games. He has started out Flannery with 3 straight fastballs. Gave him another one inside. That's kind of the secret of Rick's success. Never pitch the same way to a hitter twice in a row, or the same game, never try to pitch it twice in a row. Always keep him guessing. There's a slow curve hit up toward second. Hubbard will have it. And there's one down. Now Tony Gwynn. Gwynn batting 298 for the year. He has 4 home runs, 27 RBIs. And Mailer's first pitch, another fastball, 0-1. Gwynn right now ranks 6th in the National League in hitting. Only Dave Parker, Gary Templeton, Tommy Herr, Pedro Guerrero, and Willie McGee have a higher batting average. 1-1. 1 man out in the top half of the first inning. This is the first of a 3-game series. In the center field, that drops for a base hit. So Tony Gwynn becomes the first base runner of the evening. And Steve Garvey will step in. Very easy to see why the Padres are not scoring many runs of late. Their batting averages have really plummeted. Garvey, normally in the 280s, comes into this game at 263. 13 homers, 49 RBIs. Gwynn's going on the first pitch. There's the throw by Cerrone, and they got him. Well, John, you mentioned at the outset of the broadcast the Padres have not been running very well. Tony Gwynn, one of the guys on the club who can run, and if he gets caught stealing, there's really hardly any other threats in that lineup.
In fact, there are no other threats. Cerrone guns down Gwynn. Last year, the Padres, with Wiggins leading the way, stole 150 bases. This year, at these figures, they would steal 48.
Count goes to 1-1 on Steve Garvey. That was the eighth time Tony Gwynn had been caught stealing. He has been successful stealing eight times, and that's the league or the team leading total. Eight stolen bases.
You look at the rest of their players in their lineup, Garvey and Nettles and Kennedy and Martinez, none of them can run at all.
Second baseman Glenn Hubbard in shallow right. That's good play. Good play, Glenn Hubbard. Inning over. Hubbard had to throw against his body, but he got it on to first in time to retire Garvey, and nothing doing for San Diego in the top half of inning number one. Here's a look at the Padres defensively, and this is pretty much with the exception of Wiggins, the unit that won a National League pennant last year. An outfield of Martinez, McReynolds, and Gwynn. Infield of Nettles, Templeton, Flannery, the change at second base. Then Garvey at first. Terry Kennedy doing the catching. Eric Schau on the mound tonight with a record of 7-7. Earned run average of 3.42. There's his lifetime record. Six of those wins, only one of those losses have come to the Braves. He's been in a bit of a slump. He hasn't won a game since the 4th of July. He is making his 22nd start of the year, his first of the season against Atlanta. Claudel Washington leads it off, batting 286, 10 homers, 28 RBIs. And the first pitch from Schau is a fastball over for a call strike. Dave Dravecki goes against Joe Johnson tomorrow night. Andy Hawkins against Zane Smith on Thursday night. The Giants come in over the weekend. Down that left field line, a long run for Carmelo Martinez. He will not get to it. It's a foul ball. It's a foul ball. That almost hit the chalk.
Martinez not really fast enough to get to the ball, and the ball just landed outside of the foul line. There are a lot of people who think Carmelo Martinez eventually will be the first baseman here in San Diego because Garvey has a lock on that job now.
Well, we'll see if the outfield shades Washington a little more. They really had him swung around toward right the last pitch. There may be a step or two more toward left now. And the 0-2 is a breaking ball that missed high. No score, bottom half of the first. One other game in the National League today. Cardinals clobbered Chicago 11-3. Got him on a slow curve. One away. Now Rafael Ramirez trying to battle his way out of a mild slump. He's only 3 for his last 26. Ramirez at 273 for the year, 4 homers, 34 runs driven in. Off the glove of Schau, Templeton, good play behind the bag at second, got him. Score that one, 1-6-3. And it's out number 2 in the inning.
Here's a dandy play by Templeton. Off of the crack of the bat, it goes off Schau's glove, but Tempe gets it, makes an easy play out of it.
Two men gone, bottom half of the first, and Dale Murphy steps in. Murphy at 289, leading the league with 26 home runs and 77 RBIs. He's been in a tear of late, 16 runs driven in the last 12 ball games for Murphy. Breaking ball misses, ball one. No score, bottom half of the first. An overcast night here in Atlanta where we've had an awful lot of rain dating back to last week. The count is 2-0. Yankees and Cleveland playing a twilight doubleheader tonight. In game one, they're in the sixth inning. Cleveland leading New York 3-1. That'll be out of play. Two balls and a strike now on Murphy. Yeah. 2-1 pitch coming. Upstairs, 3-1. Up the middle, base hit center field. So Murphy becomes the first Atlanta base runner. And now the red-hot Bob Horner will step in. Horner has his season average now up to .292 with 20 homers, 61 RBIs. He's hit 8 of those home runs and driven in 22 runs in the last 13 games. And look at how the improvement in Horner's season has come along as that wrist has grown stronger. He takes a strike 0-1. I would guess San Diego a little bit disappointed in the performance of Eric Schau to this point. He was a 15-game winner last year, a 15-game winner the year before. He's won only 7 so far this year. And this is the 100th game of the season for the Padres. At his current rate, he'll win no more than 10 or 11 games. The 0-2 foul, back out of play. Again, the look toward Murphy and the 0-2 pitch. Looked like a palm ball, missed inside 1-2. Braves have an honorary bat boy today, Rick Smith. His father is the security guard in the Braves locker room here at Atlanta Fulton County Stadium. Rick celebrating a birthday today as a Braves bat boy. Here's the 1-2, fastball caught the inside corner. Horner didn't like that call. Second strike out of the inning. End of the game for Eric Schau. Take another look at strike three as we go out at the end of one. No score. Nettles leads off inning number 2 for San Diego. He's having a pretty good year. .264, 11 homers, 34 RBIs. RBI total a little low. And he's retired on one pitch. Now Terry Kennedy, the Padres catcher at .262, 9 homers, 57 RBIs. You know, John, what's so remarkable about the slide of the Padres is I can recall seeing quotes by other managers in the National League around the 4th of July saying, well, there's really nobody in the National League West quite capable of catching this San Diego team. Man for man, they were just too strong, and it certainly hasn't been that way at all.
Isn't it something, I think, around that time, too, Pete, that all of us were saying, gee, the second year in a row, no one's made a challenge at San Diego. How would they play if someone was on their neck? And now we're seeing San Diego really go the other way.
The first real slump they've been in, well, since the 1983 season. They are 7-14 since the 4th of July. One ball, one strike on Kennedy.
Well, one thing they really do miss is Alan Wiggins. I don't think you can. I think Jerry Royster and Tim Flannery have done a very fine job there. They really miss Wiggins' base-dealing ability at the top of the lineup.
2-1, the count on Kennedy. Some other games getting underway now. We'll check the scores after this pitch. Out of play, 2-2. Houston's at Cincinnati tonight, no score after a half inning. Philadelphia at Pittsburgh, no score after one. Montreal failed to score in the top of the first at New York. The Giants are playing Los Angeles at Dodger Stadium. Here There's the 2-2 hit down that third baseline. That's a fair ball, maybe more than one. We'll see how quickly Harper can get to that ball. Kennedy will head for second. He'll be in easily. Hit number two off Rick Mailer. For Kennedy, his 20th double of the year.
Well, let's look at the pitch. It's outside, and Kennedy simply goes with it, strokes it, and it goes right over the third base bag for the double.
So Kennedy in scoring position with one down. Carmelo Martinez, the hitter. He's batting 243, 13 homers, 41 runs driven in. Takes a curve for a strike, 0-1. And the American League, Chicago got a run in the top of the first. Boston now batting. Red hot Toronto, 2. Baltimore batting in the bottom of the first. Indians lead the Yankees 3-1 in the sixth of game one of their doubleheader. Here we're scoreless in the top of the second. One man out, Kennedy down at second base. And a count of one ball, one strike on Carmelo Martinez. Got the fastball by. He's throwing that fastball much more often in the first couple of innings tonight than he normally does.
I think Rick thought a few weeks ago that people were starting to sit on that slow curve and hit the slow curve, and so he's made the change. He's such a good pitcher.
He's a thinking pitcher. He really thinks about his start before he goes out there, how he wants to go about getting the hitters out. You know, some guys have great arms. They don't have to do that. They can just go out and pitch the same way every time and get by with it. But other pitchers have to really work on a hitter. Mailer's one of those types. I don't think Dwight Gooden thinks too much about how he's going to go about getting a hitter out. 95-mile-an-hour fastballs and 92-mile-an-hour curveballs normally do it. Oh. Plate umpire Lanny Harris almost called him out on that pitch. Rick Mailer thought he should have.
You can see Lanny Harris start to shrug the shoulders to throw the right hand up. Watch. Oh. Almost, but not quite.
You can also see the reaction of Rick Mailer to that call. 3-2, drilled high and deep to right center field. Murphy going back. He's not going to get to it. Off the wall. That'll score Kennedy. A run-scoring double for Carmelo Martinez, and San Diego jumps on top. RBI number 42 for Martinez, his 18th double of the season.
That's a great example of something you'll read in the newspaper. Someone on the Braves will say, hey, we had that guy struck out, and then he hits the double against the right center field wall.
So the Padres have taken the lead. Here's Kevin McReynolds. His average down at 236, but he still has 57 RBIs. 11 home runs. He and Terry Kennedy tied for the RBI lead on this ball club. One out in the inning, one run in. Fastball for a strike, 0-2.
Now, Pete, we've been talking about the Padres being six behind the loss column on L.A., five back. The other winner last year in the National League, the Chicago Cubs, are now 10 games back in the loss column with their beating today.
Yeah, their pitching staff is just about falling apart now. Looks like Sutcliffe's out for the year. Trout is out. They've been hit hard by injuries. I know it's a cliche, but it's very true. If you have a strong ball club, you're only going to be as strong as you are healthy. If injuries hit some key people on your club, you're going to have trouble winning. That was one of the keys to San Diego's success last year. Throughout the season, the regular season, they really didn't have a serious injury on their club. Well, that's something Rick Mailer certainly didn't want to do. Ahead 0-2 in the count. Kevin McReynolds down to first, hit by a Rick Mailer pitch.
And with a count, Mailer just trying to come inside on the fastball, but got it too far in, and it went right in on McReynolds, hit him on the arm.
So runners are now at first and second. And here's the best number eight hitter in baseball, Gary Templeton, batting 302 with three homers, 36 RBIs. He brings a five-game hitting streak into this one.
toward left center. That's a base hit. It should score a run. Terry Harper will throw to third. Carmelo Martinez trots home. It's 2-0 San Diego. RBI number 37 for Gary Templeton. That's the third hit of the inning, the fourth of the game off Rick Mailer.
Terry Harper thinks about it, but really he doesn't have that strong an arm. The crowd wanted him to throw, but if he had thrown to the home plate area, the runners would have moved up and the Padres would have had second and third, so Harper just stopped the runners from moving up. Now Eric Schau will go down and talk to Ozzie Virgil, the third base coach, about if they want the bunt or what pitch they might want the bunt.
Schau on the year batting 116. No homers, one RBI. This is only the seventh meeting of the year between Atlanta and San Diego. Three wins apiece in the season series thus far, counting tonight's game. 12 games left between these two clubs. Here's the 1-0. He's swinging. 1-1. Two runs in here in the top half of inning two. Cincinnati just picked up a couple of runs in the first inning. They lead Houston 2-0. Here's the 1-1. Schau is squaring this time. That's a foul ball. They count 1-2. Braves have been right on Houston's tail of late. Houston in an awful tailspin. The Braves only a game out of fourth place, but still a distant 14 out of first. Didn't get the curve. It remains 1-2. Yankees have now taken a 4-3 lead over Cleveland. They go to the eighth inning of their first game. And the 1-2 pitch, Schau squaring again, bunts it foul, and that's a strikeout for Rick Mailer, his first. Out number two in the inning, back to the top of the order, Tim Flannery. I don't know who coined this, but somewhere along the way, when Flannery and Royster began sharing second base, someone out in San Diego began combining the two names. They call the second base position Timmy Flanster, and they keep numbers on it. And
yes,
now the two
I've
of them are doing together. You've all heard the story about the answering machines and Mr. Flannery's phone and Mr. Royster's phone. Slowly towards second, Glenn Hubbard on to Horner to end the inning. But San Diego picks up a couple. We go to the bottom half of the second. The Braves down by two. Harper trying to battle out of a 2-for-21 slump. His average now at 261 for the year. 12 home runs, 51 runs driven in. Ball one. And the 1-0 coming is a breaking ball, missing high. Eric Schau, very interesting individual. See if that'll stay in play back near the screen. Catcher Terry Kennedy gives it a look, but it's out of play. Two and one the count. Schau, 29 years old, from Riverside, California. He was a physics major at the University of California at Riverside. He's a guitar player, avid reader. a politically involved young man out on the West Coast. And he's behind in the count, 3-1 on Terry Harper. Roller coaster kind of year for Harper. So-so start, good May, slow June, hot July. That ball's tagged, left center field. McReynolds and Martinez, watch it go out of here. Home run number 13 for Terry Harper. It's 2-1. Delivers.
He gets a low fastball and rides it out. Pete, you're right. He goes up and down, but he doesn't stay down for very long. He comes back with a rash of hits. That may be the signal of a new start.
Yeah, Obergefell taking a strike. Obergefell at 280 on the air, one homer, 22 RBIs. One and one. Chow, a quick worker. That pop up in foul territory, third base side. Nettles over there. One gone in the second inning. You'll have a lot of Little League coaches, Babe Ruth League coaches looking on that will tell their players, never catch a fly ball that way off of the side of your body. But Mr. Nettles, been around quite a few years, folks.
Yeah, and also you can do it if you have the talent. Greg Nettles has the talent. He has fabulous hands. Anything he gets near, he just catches.
Here's the catcher, Rick Cerrone, batting 227. Two homers, 15 runs driven in. One ball, no strikes. By the way, those of you who are wondering, Pascual Perez is in uniform tonight, or at least he was before the game, working out with the team. There he is. Back in a Brave uniform. He spoke to his teammates prior to the game. Nettles has another chance. Two down.
And Pascual had a haircut, which I need desperately. I'm sorry, Pete. I know you don't. I'm sorry.
Well, mine comes up, I think, about September. Like paying your taxes, getting a haircut, yeah. Something you have to do every year, you know. Yeah. Glenn Hubbard, the batter, batting 228, four home runs, 30 RBIs. Nothing in one account. Slow curve, and Hubbard way out in front, 0-2. Hubs in a slump, 1-for-23. Back to Pascual Perez for a moment. He remains on the restricted list. He is expected to throw batting practice a couple of times this week. And the Braves will decide later in the week when to activate him. Into center field. That'll drop for a base hit. Braves getting some pretty good cuts at Eric Schau. That's the third hit off the San Diego right-hander. And it'll bring up pitcher Rick Mailer. One of the better hitting pitchers in baseball, 194 for this year. No homers, seven RBIs. Oh, and one the count. Two runs, four hits for San Diego. One run, three hits for Atlanta. We're in the bottom half of inning two. Two men out, Hubbard at first, an 0-1 pitch coming. One ball, one strike. Now the 1-1 on the way. Didn't get the hard slider, 1-2.
Hey,
Long look toward first before the 1-2 pitch, which is a breaking ball, popped up right side of the infield. Tim Flannery in foul territory ends the inning. But the Braves pick up one on the Terry Harper home run. And after two, Atlanta remains down, but only by one now. In the top of the third, Tony Gwynn, Steve Garvey, and Greg Nettles. New up against Rick Mailer. Padres on top by one. Gwynn had a base hit his first time. One ball, no strikes. His younger brother, Chris, recently drafted by the Dodgers. Out of the same baseball program at San Diego State. 1-1 the count. Missed inside with a fastball, 2-1. Of Mailer, Oberg fell with good instinct right there, throws it out. There are some third basemen who would not have made that play. They would have been caught too far away from the ball.
Well, it's the second play of that type we've had, one on each side. It goes off the heel of Mailer's glove, and Oberg fell is right there, and Horner goes down to get the low throw.
So one down in the third. Steve Garvey the batter. He grounded out to second his first time. Fell gets another chance. Very quickly, two away.
Hey, Pete, you were talking about the Padres second baseman, Timmy Flanster. I guess that's becoming the vogue in baseball. They're now doing that in Toronto with their two third basemen, Garth Warge and Rance Mullinix. I think the name is Mullinorge.
Two down in the third. Greg Nettles the batter.
Imitation, boy.
The sincerest form of flattery.
And stealing.
By the way, we want to congratulate Terry Forster for his superlative showing on the David Letterman show last night. He handled himself well.
I bet we thought of that at the same time for the same reason, because Terry was so good, and later on in the program, John Viner did such a great Ed Sullivan. I thought that was great. Anyway, Terry Forster was sensational.
He got a little airtime too. I thought they might put him on for five minutes and that would be it. Got to show his culinary technique. Cooking a chicken taco.
Yeah.
Three and one the count on Greg Nettles. Two down in the third, San Diego with a one-run lead. Second baseman Glenn Hubbard on to Horner, and it's a 1-2-3 inning for Rick Mailer. So San Diego goes quietly in the top of the third, bottom half coming up with no change in our score. Taking a drink.
And we heard all about how they get things in the bullpen last night from Mr. Forster. Well, let me say very quickly, Terry would like me to say this, I know, that this telecast authorized under broadcasting rights granted by the Braves intended solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any publication, rebroadcast, retransmission, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, or accounts of the game out the express written consent of the Braves, turn of broadcasting prohibited.
Here's Claudel Washington, struck out his first time, takes high and outside, ball one. 2-1 San Diego, bottom of the third. And yeah, it's even now, 1-1.
I hope Ernie talks about that a bit later when he comes on with Skip in the bottom of the fifth inning. Because in the old days, Ernie's told a lot of these stories in those little old ballparks. Bullpens and bullpen pitchers used to do some crazy things.
Yeah.
see in these multi-purpose stadiums, it would take you a long time to get out. But in the old ballparks that were built into a city, you could leave on the back door, go across the street.
Door right up to the sidewalk.
Yeah.
Hot dog stand down the street or whatever. There's the 2-1 piled back 2-2. Cincinnati 2, Houston 1 now as they go to the third. Philadelphia and the Pirates no score after 3. Montreal and the Mets no score after 2. Yankees now lead Cleveland 6-3 after 8 in the first game of their doubleheader. Here's the 2-2. That fills the count. White Sox 1, Red Sox nothing after 2. Tigers have taken a 1-0 lead over Kansas City after 1. And the Blue Jays lead Baltimore 2-1 after 2. One final, Cardinals beat the Cubs 11-3. Shallow center field, Kevin McReynolds right there. One down. Now the shortstop, Rafael Ramirez. He had a ball back up the middle in the first inning that glanced off the glove of Shaw. Shortstop Gary Templeton came up with it and threw him out. Nothing and one the count. Looked like a palm ball. One ball, one strike. Joe Colley on the mound for New York tonight. In the first of that doubleheader, he's still in there with a 6-3 lead over Cleveland. Two balls and a strike on Ramirez. What a strange story about the Yankees. Who's managing that ball club? Billy Martin hospitalized, supposedly hospitalized. Lou Piniella has been asked to run the club in his absence, but there are people in Arlington, Texas that claim they saw Billy Martin out to dinner last night.
Yeah, it is kind of an odd hospitalization. He left and had a meal out with friends and then went back to the hospital and allegedly was on the phone with Piniella.
Here's the 2-2 pitch. Hit foul off to the right. It remains 2-2.
In fact, I don't know if we should talk about the doctor involved and what happened, but that is a crazy story. I would not want that to happen to me.
Well, in case folks haven't heard, Billy had some back spasms and he had a shot for the back spasms and suffered a punctured lung. There's the first walk issued by Eric Schell. Ramirez at first with one down. Dale Murphy will step in. Murph had a base hit his first time up. He has that batting average back up over 290 now. It's at 291. Ramirez represents the potential tying run at first. One man out. Ball, no strikes. Shaw works a lot more slowly with runners aboard. Took a bad bounce off the glove of Flannery to right field. Ramirez will try for third. He'll make it easily. It'll be a base hit. That ball looked like a potential double play ball when it left Murphy's bat, but when it took that bad hop, Flannery had no chance. Murphy's 2-for-2.
And Murphy going to right field hits it awfully hard. And that ball just exploded and went high and off the outstretched glove of Flannery. Now the Braves have first and third one out and Bob Horner.
That's the fourth hit off Eric Schau. Runners are at the corners with one down. Horner, a strikeout victim his first time. They'll be announcing a National League Player of the Month for the month of July. That'll be coming up in a couple of days. And you're looking at a leading candidate for that award. Downstairs, ball one. Murphy off first, Ramirez off third. And the 1-0. Driven to center field, should be deep enough to score the run. McReynolds waiting out there. Ramirez will tag, breaks toward the plate. Here comes the throw. He just got in there. That was a good throw by Kevin McReynolds, and Kennedy had the plate blocked. Ramirez just able to sneak a foot in there. The game is tied 2-2.
And you know, if Kennedy had done a better job blocking the plate, the Braves might not have scored. Tremendous throw by McReynolds all the way in on one bounce. And watch the open spot. There it is. And the run scores as Ramirez goes between Kennedy's legs to hit the plate.
RBI number 62 for Bob Horner. We've got a 2-2 ball game. Each club with four hits. Murphy still the runner at first. And here's the man that accounted for the other run, Terry Harper, who hit his 13th homer. Murphy is running. The throw by Kennedy. In there safely. Murphy hasn't run much this year. That's only his fifth stolen base in six tries. But you're going to see the Braves run against the Padres. They've not thrown many people out.
If you didn't see the open, we talked about this. The Padres have stolen 31 bases, and the opponents have now stolen 94. And have only thrown out, the Padres only thrown out 37 men.
Here's the 1-0, 1-1. Tell you what, though, looking at that replay, we saw the ball pop out of Flannery's glove. That ball had Murphy beat down at second base. It's a little bit of a break there for the Braves.
Of course, we can out the Braves, too. The Braves are next to last in stolen bases, right underneath the Padres, or right over the Padres.
1-1 is popped up, foul territory, first base side. It'll drop out of play. One ball, two strikes on Harper. And the 1-2 pitch. Fly ball, fairly deep left center field, but this one's playable. McReynolds is there. He's got it. And the inning's over. But a walk, a single, and a sacrifice fly by Bob Horner. And at the end of three, the game is now tied. The totals are identical through three. Two runs, four hits, no errors for San Diego. Two runs, four hits, no errors for Atlanta. Top half of the fourth, Terry Kennedy leads it off, and here's John Sterling.
Okay, Peter, thank you. Once again, good evening, everyone. And Mela's first pitch is outside, ball one. So the Braves have battled back after being down 2-0. A home run by Harper, a sack fly by Bob Horner, which tied at two here in the fourth. Terry Kennedy had a double his first time. He has not been hitting well, but he's driven in 57 runs this year. Good for ninth in the league. And the count 2-1. He's not a great defensive catcher, so I guess you notice it more when he's not hitting. But he's a pretty darn good hitter. There's another example as he lines the base hit to left field. So he's doubled down the third baseline. Now lines a single to left, and the Padres have a good start to their fourth.
It's very unusual to see him go the opposite way twice in a ball game. It's unusual to see him go that way once in a ball game.
Martinez doubled in the second inning. That knocked Kennedy in. Right-hand hitter with a lot of power. Fouls that one off his foot.
Martinez was a first baseman in the Cub organization. And a lot of the Padre people think that's where he should be playing. However, Garvey's at first base, so Martinez for the second year is playing left field, and he kind of battles left field. But he's got an awful lot of power. And like a lot of young power hitters, the book on Martinez, throw him breaking stuff. There's a fastball for a strike, and I guess Martinez was looking for the breaking stuff because he took a fastball right down the pipe. Lee Cobb, one of the TBS tape operators, wants to wish a happy birthday to Diane Armstrong in Largo, Florida. There's the curveball in the dirt. We'd like to say hello to Mike Wardell, big Braves fan, who's rooting for the Braves tonight. The curveball is popped foul out of play, and the count holds 1-2. Martinez to be followed by Kevin McReynolds. We're in the top of the fourth, tied at 2. And the Padres, who've had a long homestand, which they did very poorly in, now have to get back at the Dodgers on the road. The count evens 2-2. You know, it's funny, last year, Pete, we all said after the All-Star break, well, the Padres have a lot of road games, so we'll be able to catch them. They'll go on the road, but they played very well on the road. This year, the Padres all said, now we've got all these home games. Doesn't work out that way all the time. Slow bouncer, Rafi has to hustle to get one. He does.
Well, they had that long homestand. They won the first three games against the Pirates, and then they lost 6 of the next 7 at home.
And, of course, it's coincided with the Dodgers playing the best baseball in the National League. So L.A. has a big lead, 5 games and 6 on the loss side. One away, Kennedy went on to second base, and here's McReynolds. McReynolds suffering from the old sophomore jinx. He's had a very poor second year, and he had a terrific year last year. He's got power and speed. Here's one guy who can run in their lineup. Claudel gives it a little bit of a look, but it's out of play. And the count 0-2.
This crowd, by the way, will put the Braves over the million mark for the season. They needed only 7,000, and they've got, well, I guess somewhere around 20, 25,000 tonight.
Yeah, it's a good crowd, and the West Coast teams coming in. First the Padres, then the Giants over the weekend, then the Dodgers before the Braves go away to the West Coast. So the fans have been great, no question about it. Braves have not played good at all this year, and the fans have been sensational. Oh, the change just outside. And the count 1-2. But I think the fans will enjoy coming out tomorrow night and seeing Joe Johnson pitch. He is a terrific-looking rookie pitcher. Boy, he took something off. McReynolds out ahead.
Sometimes you'll see Mailer use this pitch to set up his fastball for a strikeout. He's been using his fastball to set up his breaking stuff against a lot of the hitters tonight.
They're going to walk Gary Templeton, which is a dandy idea, with Schau coming up next, and Kennedy in scoring position at second place. So the intentional walk, and Templeton will be at first, and they'll go after Eric Schau with 2 outs here in the fourth. Ironically, the Padres having such an off year in so many respects, Gary Templeton is having really one of the best years of his career. Pete, he has rebounded kind of all the way back from where he was with the Cards. I mean, he's not the same player because of the knee operations, but he's been a terrific player.
Good hitter. Good defensive shortstop. His stolen base total way down from what it once was, but he's a good one.
And the Padres really sing his praises. Well, there's first and second, 2 out. Here is Eric Schau. Schau struck out trying to bunt his first time. As a hitter this year, he's 5-for-44. No homers and an RBI. First and second, two outs. And the curveball way outside, ball one.
Let's not sell the Padres too short, though. I think if you ask anybody in the National League, they would still tell you that man for man, they, on paper, look like the best club in the Western Division.
It's true, though. That's the key word, on paper. Curveball is missed in. They count 1-1. They certainly have the best starting eight.
What they need to do right now is get their momentum back. You know, they've gone into one of those tailspins, and you've got to halt that somewhere along the line. If you don't, well, you just keep falling further back.
That fastball missed, and the count 2-1. A gentleman with the glasses and mustache looking on, of course, the great Padre manager, Dick Williams. Two with a fastball and hits the outside. Mailer in outstanding position to win 20 games. And maybe by the end of August, he's 15-8. Curveball bends outside. It's a full count. And that's a big plus for Terry Kennedy, who doesn't run well at second base.
It's been a funny kind of a season for Rick Mailer. He was disappointed, first of all, for not getting selected to the National League All-Star team. Now he's on course for a 20-win season, but of course there's a strike looming that might prevent that.
Bob Horner will make the play, as he's been doing at first base since moving over there. Mailer covers. And no runs for the Padres. On a hit, they leave two. At the end of 3.5 innings of play, the score, the Padres 2, the Braves 2. Here's the top of the order. Tim Flannery to lead off for San Diego. We're tied at 2, top of the fifth. Mailer will make the play himself. One down.
What was surprising about those numbers, they only were one game over 500 against right-hand pitching. You wouldn't think that with Flannery and Gwynn and Nettles and Kennedy. They got some pretty good left-hand bats in their lineups.
They do. Talking about their ball club with their one of their broadcasters, Jerry Coleman, he said the Padres have had trouble winning one-run games, too. I guess when you lose, you get a whole bunch of problems that Padres didn't have last year. Tony Gwynn takes it high at ball one, but basically this team has missed Allen, Wiggins, and Gwynn setting the table. Oh, he's an artist, isn't he, with the bat? Inside-out stroke down the left field line. It'll be a double for Tony Gwynn. Gwynn now 2-for-3, and he can really handle that stick.
He's just one of those hitters that uses the whole field, doesn't try to hit home runs. He was the batting champion in the National League last year. See what that pitch was down around the knees, outside corner? Just go with it. Hit it down the left field line.
He really has that back control, though. He can.
You give him that same pitch in the inside corner, he'll pull it down the right field line.
Yeah, he takes a long look. He just has talent, that's all. Great talent. And he's a good guy, too. He's at second base, and with one man out here, Steve Garvey. Now, Gwynn does have good speed at second base. It's funny, isn't it, how stealing or doing anything else, I guess, becomes part of a team movement. Last year, Gwynn stole something like 30 or 40 bases because he had Allen Wiggins on base, getting everyone jittery. This year he doesn't have him, and Gwynn hasn't been stealing much. The wave is hit Atlanta, 0-2 on Garvey. Gwynn has stolen 8 times, but he's been caught 7 times. That's not very good, so I guess he doesn't run much anymore. Full foul and deep down the left field line, out of play. We're in the top of the fifth, tied at two. Tony Gwynn at second base and a 1-2 count on Garvey. The curveball pops him up to short. Ramirez two away. Now here's an amazing play of Greg Nettles. Nettles really having a good season. He doesn't play all the time. He plays most of the time at third base. Hitting at 264, 11 homers, 34 RBIs. 264 is higher than his major league norm. And Greg Nettles is in his early 40s. Play that saved a run. And he throws Greg out. Mailer doesn't stab that. That ball goes through to center field and Gwynn scores. No runs on a hit, no errors, and one left. Ernie and Skip will come over in just a minute as we go over toward radio. At the end of four and a half, the ball game is all tied at two.
Johnson, Skip Carey with you as we go to the bottom of the fifth inning. 2-2. Tim Flannery at second, his first time. One ball, no strikes. Padres lead and hit 6-4, but where it counts, we're even at two. With a fastball by him and a home run cut, it's 1-1. Public relations director of the Atlanta Falcons, Charlie Dayton, out at the ballpark tonight with his lovely bride, Lynn. The 1-1. Low and away, it's 2-1. Falcons get it rolling August 10th with their preseason schedule. The 2-1 pitch. Fly ball. Easy play, McReynolds. One out in the bottom of the fifth. Here's Claudell Washington, nothing for two. He has struck out. He has flagged the center. To go to work. Broken bat pop, that's not playable. So as Washington gets a new war club, we'll point out to you that Eric Schau is a member of the John Birch Society, so naturally he pitches from the right side. Oh, and one, the count to Claudell.
Now, if he were a left-hander,
he couldn't, obviously wouldn't be in that organization. No. He'd be in Students for Democratic Action or something like that. Oh, and one is the count. Let up, broke the bat again. Templeton fields the ball. Garvey dodges the bat, and Washington's out of there. It was a weird time at bat for him. He splintered lumber all over the place.
They got to be jam jobs. Got to be right in on the hams. Mm-hmm. That was a slider. There's part of it.
Rafael 0 for 1 with a walk and a run scored. At the letters, nothing and one. Two out. out, nobody aboard. Bottom of the fifth. Hanging way out in front. He pulled the string or threw him a dead fish or whichever cliche you prefer.
He hasn't used many of those today, but he got Cerrone on one.
Came back with one, but had it high and inside. A ball, two strikes. Goodbye. On the outside corner, Ramirez didn't think so, but that is strikeout number four for Shaw. Three of them have been called. Nothing doing in the Atlanta fifth. We go to the sixth. Tied 2-2.
Rolaids knows. On this assembly line, the crew gets heartburn. And when they do, they can't stop. No wonder millions take Rolaids. Rolaids antacid medicine consumes 100% of the acid required to give millions 100% relief. With Rolaids, you can keep going. Rolaids. Rolaids spells 100% relief.
And now, there's sodium-free Rolaids for sodium-free relief.
I'm a hero with the kids. Even the hot dogs taste good.
We ask people who love to cook out about the charcoal they cook with.
You use the best meat, you can use the best coal. Kingsford charcoal.
It's a smoky charcoal taste. It's not the same as you get anywhere else.
Yeah, a lot of times you use Kingsford, you don't have to put any sauce on it. Yeah,
I use the Kingsford because I can count on it.
Kingsford's the best.
I can't wait for that first bite.
It's as good as mom and apple pie, I think.
I'm going to Kingsford, Kingsford tonight.
In no time at all, Delta can get you to the Bahamas with daily flights to Nassau, where you can enjoy the sun, the beaches, and the crystal clear water. A Delta Dream Vacation packages the pleasure of the Bahamas to fit your budget. For details, see your travel agent or call Delta. It's beautiful in the Bahamas, especially at our prices.
He turned a bunch of prisoners into a team of soldiers. Charlton Heston is Major Dundee at 10:20 Eastern on the Superstation tonight.
And now we'll bring you part of the top of the sixth. Terry Kennedy is 0 for 2. Both his hits and all, rather he's 2 for 2, both his hits and all San Diego hits in the game have been to the off field. The 0-1. He pulls this one right at Horner. He'll take it himself. One out. And Carmelo Martinez, the batter, he doubled home a run, later scored one back in the second. He's 1 out of 2. His double went to right center. Two 6-0 for the Padres, 2-4-0 for the Braves. Ball high and away. Montreal and the Mets scoreless after four. Gullickson and Gooden hooked up in that one. Cincinnati 2-1 over Houston after four. Ryan and Soto pitching there. Phillies and Kevin Gross after five lead the Pirates 2-0. Cardinals won their seventh straight against the Cubs today, 11-3 in Wrigley Field, and the Dodgers and Giants play later. This low and away.
Cubs continue to have their problems, and they might not be over. I don't know if they made a decision on Rick Sutcliffe or not, but there was a story today that he might be through for the year because of that leg problem.
Martinez walks on four straight. And here's Kevin McReynolds, who's fighting it a little bit. He's 0 for 2 today, down to... I think he's 0 for 1 today, down to 234 on the year. He was hit by a pitch his first trip. A little low with a fastball. Both Mailer and Cerrone wanted that one. Coming into this game, the Braves earned run average for their last nine games over six.
Too much.
2-0, and all of a sudden the plate begins to jump around on Rick Mailer. He hit it hard, but foul past third. Fan has a net down there, a la Ernie Johnson.
This is prettier. I think they got a ball earlier tonight. Yeah, I think they did. Yeah.
Well, then it's certainly different than yours.
It certainly is, Ollie.
Two balls and a strike. McReynolds waits. A little tap. Not fast enough to get a double play. They get one there. That's the second out of the inning. Keeps the runner out of scoring position. And McReynolds is at first with two out for Gary Templeton, who singled and walked. Mark Goldsmith, our director tonight. Mike Reardon, our producer. Dick Fontaine, our associate director. Oh. 1-0 to Templeton. When you hit over 300 batting eighth, you're having a heck of a year because you don't see that many good pitches to hit with a hitter with a pitcher hitting behind you.
He's having one of his best years. Templeton looking like the guy that got 100 hits lefty and 100 righty as a Cardinal when he was much younger.
If he'd have stayed healthy, boy, he's a Hall of Fame candidate here. But his knees have... He's still a fine player, but not what he once was. Took a shot at left field. They're all going the other way, but he fouled that one off.
It's very similar to Vince Coleman when he came to the Cardinals years ago. Templeton could just scare you to death. He hit a ground ball to short. He'd beat it out. He'd go first to third on every single. Really ran the bases well. Super speed.
Did he go? Yes. Swung at a terrible pitch. For something off spin, and Mailer fooled him. Records his third strikeout. No hits, no runs, no errors. They leave a runner, and we go to the bottom of the sixth, all tied at two.
Does your camera take away your creativity? Take off with a Canon T50. Take shots you always wanted to take. Close shots, action shots, and take it easy with a Canon T50 with automatic exposure, auto load, and auto advance. Plus, choose from over 50 Canon lenses and even an automatic flash. So take off with a Canon T50. Enter the Canon photo contest and win a trip to a national park. Details at dealers.
Give me a light.
Go. Bud Light.
If you just ask for a light beer, you never know what you'll get.
Give me a light. Bud Light.
So if you want the less filling light beer with the first name and taste, don't just ask for a light beer.
Give me a light.
Ask them to bring out their best.
Bud Light.
Bud Light.
Thank you.
Because everything else is just a light.
We asked smokers to take the Topol stain test. Look at the results.
It's disgusting.
Yuck. It looks like the bottom of an ashtray.
Nicotine can stain your teeth the same way. That's why if you smoke, you should use Topol Smoker's Tooth Polish to help get rid of ugly tobacco stains.
I brush with it. I see my teeth are whiter than they were. I feel better. I feel more at ease.
Well, I smile a lot, and I think that says it all.
For whiter, brighter teeth, get Topol Smoker's Tooth Polish.
Braves umbrellas, folding chairs, keychains, they're just some of the items in the Braves Clubhouse Collection catalog. To receive your catalog, send your name, address, and $1 to Braves Catalog, Post Office Box 4064, Atlanta, Georgia, 30302. You'll receive a coupon worth $1 toward your first catalog order.
Well, this would be a good inning for the Braves to get something going. Murphy, Horner, and Harper will be the first three against Eric Shaw. We're in a 2-2 ballgame. Up high and inside, 1-0. Murph has hit the ball hard twice. He's 2 out of 2. One of them, I think, should have been in air. Should have been a double play, but he got a break. 2 balls, no strikes. Murph takes a long look at Bobby Wine, his third base coach.
You'd think they'd let him hit if he liked it.
We'll never know, and he's aboard. Shaw issues a second walk. That's the lead run on to lead off the Atlanta sixth inning, and here's Bob Horner, who was not National League Player of the Week. Pedro Guerrero out hit him by 100 points, though Horner had more homers, more RBIs. But Guerrero had a string of reaching base safely 14 straight times, so you can't really argue with him getting the honor.
Well, Horner might have a shot at Player of the Month. He's had a good month, too.
The knees, 0-1. Horner struck out in the first, was called out, drove in a run with a sacrifice fly in the third, and he bats here in the sixth. Up high with the off-speed breaking ball. Evens the count, 1-1. Breaking ball, it's 1-2. There's a good look at Eric Shaw, who's not only active in political causes, very active in charity work in the San Diego area. Pop the curve ball back, right over our heads into the upper deck. It stays a ball and two strikes. Down the right side, Gwynn has a long going to get there, and it doesn't matter. It bounced out of the picnic area into the seats. There's nobody out. Murphy is at first, and the count is a ball and two strikes on the Braves cleanup batter, Bob Horner. That lollipop curveball and got it up again. It's 2-2. Now the question is, did he show him that to set up the fastball?
He got him with a fastball first time up. Horner didn't agree with the call. It was on the inside part.
Well, let's see what he offers up on the 2-2 pitch.
Three might be a slider.
Chases Murphy back. Dale stole a base earlier here. His fifth and sixth try. Braves are 44 of 68 stolen bases. Padres are worse, 31 of 56.
First he said fastball in, then he went to the slider. Let's see.
Slider fouled up. Not a very good one. He got that up a little bit. Fan in the first row of the upper deck had that one in his hands and let it elude him, and that's why you heard the boos. B-O-O-S. 2-2 to Horner. Foul tipped into the glove of Kennedy for a strikeout. He had a good cut at a high fastball, but he didn't get it. Shaw's fifth strikeout.
They're using the last sign, it appears. He gave him the other signs, came back with a fastball sign. Of course, they can switch it any time. And he struck out Horner now twice on fastball, and it's not easy.
Harper has homered his 13th, driving in his 52nd runner, and he's flied to deep center, so he's been a tough out. There's a strike to him, nothing and one. Shaw and Mailer hooked up in a good one here. Dave Dravecki will pitch against Joe Johnson tomorrow night. We'll have it for you at 7:35 here on TBS. Fastball again. It's 0-2. I think Kennedy was crossed up. He wants to visit with Eric Shaw.
Trying to use though. Just a single sign that time. The only time they really get concerned about signs is with a runner at second base. They don't want anybody to steal them. And they use a lot more.
That slow curveball high and inside. Through five in New York, Gullickson and Gooden, nothing, nothing. Well, the Cubs 9.5 games up.
They're hurting, too. Literally.
2-2 to Harper.
They found out last year they didn't have many injuries, but Sutcliffe has been struggling. He might be out for the year. Trout has had a bad arm. Gary Matthews disabled. Dernier was out of there. Jody Davis was in the hospital. They've had a lot of problems over there this year, and it showed in the standings.
Murphy runs. Harper struck out. And Murphy is at second. First base was occupied, so Harper is out, and that might be a wild pitch. He swung at a terrible pitch. No, it won't be. It'll be a stolen base for Murphy because he was running on the pitch, his sixth. And the sixth strikeout for Shaw. It was a funny-looking play all the way around, but no foul tip. And now everybody wants to get together here and find out how badly Terry Kennedy is getting crossed up and why, because it appears he might have been two pitches in a row.
He might be talking about walking Obergefell, too. Cerrone's up next. He's a right-handed batter, and we'll know in a moment. Galen Sisco, quite an athlete in his day, Big Ten, and they're going to walk Obi to pitch to Cerrone.
And Galen Sisco, former great linebacker at Ohio State, which reminds us that our partner Pete Van Wieren and Ron Kramer will televise Big Ten football for TBS syndication this fall, while Bob Neal and Tim Foley have the SEC Game of the Week, and Lindsey Nelson and Paul Horning have a nighttime special all fall long. Football, college football action. Alex Horning and Craig Sager will be in the studios with live updates on all the other action around the nation. Walk to Obergefell, third of the night.
We want to straighten that out. Alex Hawkins, the Hawk.
What did I say?
Horning.
Alex Horning?
Yeah. Well, he doesn't work there now. Alex Horning.
Well, they remind me so much of each other that...
They frequent the same places.
Many of us do. That's still a night I'll never forget, the night I went out with those two guys in Anaheim. Meanwhile, back to the game. Here's Cerrone, and the fastball is high. One ball, no strikes.
Captain who? Alex Hawkins. So TBS is a place to be for college football.
Sunrise is beautiful in Anaheim. The 1-0 to Cerrone. It's 2-0. The leading run is in scoring position. That's Dale Murphy at second base. Obergefell is at first. There are two out. That's into left center field, and it's going to fall, and the Braves lead. Cerrone delivers a clutch base, and it's 3-2. He really cut down on his swing and just made contact and drilled it into left center. Rick drives in his 16th run, and Atlanta has the lead.
We've often said baseball is a game of hunches, so Dick Williams said, well, we don't want to go against Obergefell. Obi's a left-handed batter, and we'll go against the righty, and you saw what happens. Doesn't always work. Might work tomorrow. Today it didn't.
Glenn Hubbard tries to pad the Atlanta lead. Breaking ball for a strike, nothing and one. Hubbard has singled and bounced to third. Rick Mailer is next, but there are two out. Into left center, McReynolds will get there, and the inning is over. But the Braves break out on top on Cerrone's clutch hit. They score a run. No errors. Two left. The end of six, Atlanta 3, San Diego 2. Part of the seventh inning here, and Dick Williams is showing some faith in his ball club. He's going to let Eric Schau hit for himself here, despite the fact that he trails 3-2. Show business personality Terry Forster begins to limber up in the Atlanta bullpen, but no activity for San Diego.
Old Terry did okay last night.
Very well.
Yes, sir.
I wish they'd let him talk instead of making him cook, though.
Yeah. That was a surprise to me. Chef Boyardee.
I think the other guy was afraid of being upstaged, maybe.
I thought that Letterman was a little cautious. Couldn't figure out Terry. By the time he had him figured out, he was gone. And I thought, Terry, that's a good line.
If you can't figure him out, don't worry about him. We've known him a lot longer than you. We don't have any idea either.
No.
Schau takes a fastball outside. One ball, no strikes. Chased what would have been ball two. Braves get a break there. It's 1-1. Nobody on, nobody out.
It's a little surprising. Pitcher batting, trailing here in the seventh.
Here's Tim Flannery, who's 0 for 3. He's failed to get the ball out of the infield. He'll take a little extra time to allow Schau to get back to the dugout. Talking before on radio, I don't mean to be negative, but it really puts it in perspective in your mind, or at least in my mind, to say this could be the last Tuesday night of baseball in the 1985 season. I hope that's not the case. Could be.
I hope not, but that strike date is next Tuesday.
0-1 to Flannery.
I just have a feeling that there's got to be a compromising spot in that TV contract, whether it be 30%, 26, 20, or what have you, if they really want it to be signed, but that is the biggest point. The 30% the players have been getting of the TV contract.
strike. That does it for Flannery, three in a row. Mailer appears to be warming to the task here.
I understand today there was an offer by the owners to the players' union on the TV monies, but it was turned down.
Tony Gwynn is two out of three. Went for the pump that time, fouled it off, 0-1. Should end the inning. Mailer breezes through the seventh in 1-2-3 fashion. We go to the bottom half of the seventh inning. Braves lead it 3-2.
Reliever that smells great.
America's team, the Atlanta Braves, battle the San Diego Padres, live and in stereo at 7:35 p.m. Eastern on the Super Station tomorrow.
We go to the bottom half of the seventh inning, and here with the play-by-play story is Ernie Johnson.
Thank you, Skip. Rick Mailer at the plate, the first pitch. Fly ball right center. Win. One done. Mailer now 0 for 3. Claudel Washington's next. He's 0 for 3. He'll be followed by Ramirez. Shaw's allowed 5 hits. Mailer's allowed 6. We're just zipping along, bottom of the seventh. One ball and strike. A little bit low. Short. Templeton to first, two away in the seventh. And now Rafael Ramirez, who is 0 for 2 with a walk, he scored a run. Kennedy with a sign and Shaw with a pitch. Fly ball left. Going to be a very easy inning. Martinez with a catch. And that is a 1-2-3 in the bottom of the seventh. Coming up, the Mike and Feet of the Week with Paul Ryden.
The Feet of the Week is brought to you by the Micodin Cure for Athlete's Foot. Thursday night in Philadelphia, the Braves' domination of the Phillies continues and a new face emerges. Pitcher Joe Johnson, making his major league debut, goes 7 innings, allowing only 1 run on 3 hits. Offensively, he got help from the hottest of all Braves, Bob Horner, who hit homer number 17. He added another one the next day and 2 on Saturday to make it 4 home runs and 9 RBIs in the series, as the Braves beat Philadelphia in the season series 10-2.
In the beginning, man's feet walked free. But the road to civilization was paved, so man developed shoes. Soon after that, man developed athlete's foot.
Big guy.
Today, there's Micotin. Micotin cures athlete's foot. It's the only athlete's foot medicine you can buy with miconazole, a patented ingredient recommended by specialists to cure athlete's foot. Micotin in spray, powder, or cream. Micotin, the end of the road for athlete's foot.
Wednesday, these men will stand by what they believe in. The Savage Wilderness at 10:20 p.m. Eastern
on the Superstation Wednesday night.
Cardinals are red hot. The Cubs are now 9.5 games out. That's Soto against Ryan in Cincinnati and Gullickson against Gooden, New York, Montreal. Kevin Gross has the shutout for the Phillies. The Giants game has not yet started, and we're back to play, and here again is Ernie.
And Mailer ready to go. Backs off as Garvey steps out. Paid attendance tonight is 19,763, so the Braves go over the million mark. Strike call. Braves came in at 993,000. And the 1-0. A little bit outside. Nettles is on deck. Garvey with the Popeye forearms. The senator from Southern California bounces it right at Hubbard, a bad hop single. He hit it hard. Hubbard went to one knee to make sure, and a ball hit something and bounced over his head. So the tying runner's aboard on a bad hop single.
Not much you can do about this, except consider yourself fortunate you didn't get hit right in the face. You see, he went for it with his bare hand, but that didn't miss getting him between the eyes by much. And now Eddie Haas is on his way to the mound to talk it over with Rick Mailer.
He's got Forster and Suter in the bullpen. They're both ready. And it looks like Forster is going to be called upon. Fans don't agree with the lifting of Rick Mailer, who's pitched into the eighth inning. But they are happy that Forster's coming on, too. So they're kind of torn with their emotions. It'll be a standing ovation for Rick Mailer, who is seeking his 16th win, and he could still get it with some good relief pitching. Forster makes an appearance, and Mailer doffs his cap. As Terry takes his warm-up tosses, we'll break away for this message. Forster against Nettles. The first pitch hit foul up by first. They have Stoddard and Thurman in their bullpen. There you see the numbers on Terry Forster. Nettles is 0 for 3. Kennedy's next. He's a lefty. They don't lift him for pinch hitters, so a left-hander has to be your choice in this spot. We'll see how it works out. Garvey's at first. Almost hit Nettles, and a nice play by Cerrone. One ball and strike.
Clint Barker up again at the Braves bullpen.
One ball and strike. Well hit. Base hit. Washington going to play the carom. Garvey to third. And Nettles has a double. And the throw is off target, but Garvey holds it third. So the Padres in business. A single and a double. Tying run is at third. The go-ahead run's at second.
Breaking ball about belt high. It was on the outside part of the plate, but Nettles got those wrists through it and ripped it into the corner. A big mess for Forster now. The tying run at third, the lead run at second, and nobody out.
There's Nettles. He's at second. Garvey's at third. Kennedy the batter. Time call for a moment by Ozzie Virgil. Looks like Jerry Royster will come on as a pinch runner, and he will for Nettles.
Isn't that funny? He let Nettles hit against the left-hander, then brings the right-hand hitter in to run for him, and you can't knock the strategy, boy. It paid off.
The announcement on Royster, former Brave. Nettles, the old pro. He'll be 41 August 20th, delivers a double to put San Diego right in this thing. Nobody out, pitch to Kennedy. Missed inside, 1-0. Could be Forster's last man. They got a righty coming next. Suter's ready. 1-0. Hit foul. One ball, one strike. Joe Cowley won the first game for the Yankees over Cleveland, 8-5. Yankees winning the second, 1-0 in the third now. As you look at Suter, who is ready, and Barker, who is taking a little bit to the mitt. One ball, one strike. And the 1-1. Toward first, but foul. 1-2.
Jackson now warming up for the Padres.
They have Jackson throwing in their bullpen now. Roy Lee Jackson.
He came over in the Wiggins deal, used to pitch for Toronto.
One ball, two strikes. There's nobody out. They have runners at second and third. Forster's pitch. Hit toward Hubbard. The run will score. The out is made. The go-ahead run's now at third with one down. The Braves were playing back. They would give that tying run. Here comes Eddie Haas. He's hearing from the fans, and Bruce Suter will be called upon as we felt what happened. Right-handed hitters coming up, at least for the moment. Dick Williams could go to a lefty, but it looks like Martinez is going to bat for himself, and he'll be followed by McReynolds. So Forster is being lifted after giving up a double to Nettles and a ground out to Kennedy. Suter on a relief. It is now 3-3 with the go-ahead run at third and only one out. Forster leaving. Suter will take his warm-ups, and we'll break away for this lesson.
Great day, huh?
Some airlines seem to see how far they can push you.
Puffy!
Not Delta. We'd rather see how well we can fly you.
How about that movie, huh? Just give it a good stand.
And now with movies on selected Delta flights.
Hello?
So why be pushed from here to there?
Puffy!
When you can relax and fly Delta. Delta gets you there in style.
When do you say L.A.?
When it's after work and I'm taking work home, I say L.A.
Oh,
hey.
How about dinner?
When do you say L.A.?
When I've been playing shortstop all day and we've got a big night tonight, I say L.A.
Wrestling?
Championship from Anheuser-Busch. L.A. beer. Great taste with half the alcohol. Sometimes it's the perfect thing to say.
You can say that again.
I like wrestling.
Perfect.
L.A. Sometimes it's the perfect thing to say.
Suter against Martinez, and Suter wants to talk it over with Cerrone. Now the Braves will bring their infield up. Royster's at third base. He represents run number four, and that would put San Diego out in front. Martinez with a double back in the second inning, knocking in a run. Since then, he's grounded out and walked. As you take a look at Rick Mailer, and the first pitch is a strike from Bruce Suter. All in one. A little bit high. Mailer can't win it. Mailer can't lose it. He went seven plus, gave up seven hits, three runs, a couple of walks, and four strikeouts. The 1-1. Look out. Suter wants to keep it down and hope that he can get a ground ball rather than a fly ball. Deadman gets up now and starts throwing along with Barker. The hitter in this situation looks for a pitch up so he can hit at least the fly ball for the run. And the pitcher tries to keep it down to get the grounder. And that is over third for a base hit. Broken bat single. Royster scores, and Martinez is at first. He hit it just good enough to make it 4-3. Padres.
And the crowd boos Eddie Haas, and his strategy didn't work, and it's arguable whether Mailer should have been lifted or not, but you got to point out, too, that Forster gave up the big hit to the left-hand hitter, and Suter gave up the hit to the right-hand hitter, so they didn't get the jobs done that they hoped to do. Bruce got that pitch up a little bit, or as Ernie said, it wasn't hit well.
McReynolds to center field, Murphy with the catch. Martinez back to first. Kevin McReynolds makes out number two. Here's Gary Templeton. Atlanta with a couple of more raps. It's the top of the eighth right now. Martinez with just average speeds at first. Templeton drives it to right, but he pulled it foul. 0-1. Templeton had a single and an RBI in the second. He's walked and struck out. Braves and the Padres are 3-3 for the year. That's pretty well touched off in left center, but Murphy should catch it, and he does, short of the track. But two big runs for the Padres. We go to the bottom of the eighth, 4-3, San Diego. We're going to the bottom of the eighth inning. You see the final American League scores. Some games have been completed, not too many. Toronto's on a drive, and Kansas City in the American League West putting the push on California. Got to remember, Dick Houser does a good job with Kansas City. They won it last year, and he's driving for another one this year. Another pennant. Here's Murphy and the pitch. The ball outside. Friday night is cap night. Here at the stadium, August 3rd, Saturday, Nostalgia Night. That's a poster night. And August 4th is Photo Day. You can get down on the field and take pictures of your favorite players. As Kennedy talks to Shaw, this is about the particular way of pitching Murphy. Two heads are better than one most of the time. Most catchers don't mind a shakeoff now and then, but they also like to control the game. Here's a 1-0. Just a little bit outside, 2-0. Atlanta with two more turns, bottom of the eighth and ninth. They trail by one. Murphy is 2-for-2 today with a walk and a stolen base. And the pitch is a ball outside. Horner's on deck. The Mets got a run. They lead Montreal 1-0 in the seventh. Dwight Gooden against Gullickson. There's the goose. Gossage now throwing. He's their bread and butter guy late. That is high ball four. Murphy walks, now Horner. Dick Williams is torn. He doesn't know if he wants to go get him or not. Royce is going out to talk. Kennedy, I think here comes Williams. Here he comes. No, this is Cisco. Cisco's going to talk it over with him. I don't know what you say in this case. Don't let him hit a homer.
He's gotten Horner on strikes with fastballs twice. Bob had a sacrifice fly in the center on his other trip. What they'd like, of course, is the ground ball because Horner does not run that well.
They've also given Gossage a couple of more tosses down there because it's his first time up. They've had Stoddard throw, Thurman throw, Jackson's been up. And now Gossage. Gossage. Horner hasn't hit Shaw that well. 231, as you saw the graphic. That isn't even close. Kennedy saved him. He saved Murphy, the tying run, being at second with nobody out. That ball was way outside, a curveball breaking down, not an easy ball to handle. Sometimes it comes off there like a cue ball. 1-0. It's because of the spin, of course. Harper's on deck. Strike call. So the Braves, if they want to do anything, have the gut of their order up. Horner up there now, then Harper, followed by Obergefell. Shaw with a 1-1. Let up line. Hit. Murphy to third. And Horner to second. If they had it to do over again, they would never have thrown that ball to third base. Because they allowed Horner the go-ahead run to go to second. And as soon as Martinez threw it, he knew he had made a mistake. He had no chance to get Murphy. He allowed Horner with some alert base running to get the second.
First of all, Martinez very surprised that Murphy even tried for third on him here. You watch him. You see him there take a couple of steps, then make a terrible throw. Bad because he missed the cutoff man, and that got Horner out of double play problems. They're at second and third with nobody out. And Williams apparently is going to stay with Eric Shaw.
Harper's a batter. He's homered, fly to center, and struck out. Very good base running by Murphy, and you know why he did it. First the pitch. Pitch is high, 1-0. Murphy hitting second base knows that in 9 out of 10 of those cases, the left fielder is not going to take a chance throwing the third, so he challenges him. Martinez, instead of throwing back towards second, keeping Horner at first, and he's a winning run, potential winning run. He went through with it, and it, so far it has backfired, and that's up the middle. The tying run will score, and a runner at third is Terry Harper. Bounces to the middle, and Flannery throws him out, but Atlanta has tied it 4-4.
Again, a breaking ball, a pretty good pitch. Shaw very nearly caught that ball. If he does, he's got a double play, but he did not. Flannery had no choice, and now Horner is just 90 feet away, and you've got the left-hand hitter, Ken Obergefell, up against the right-hand hitter. Unless they walk him to set up the double play, we shall see.
Well, we were surprised that Shaw was allowed to bat in the seventh, and we're equally surprised that he's been allowed to pitch this long here in the bottom of the eighth. With Gossage, their big gun down in the bullpen. Now I'm really surprised as it pitched to Obergefell. They're going to with the infield up, and there's a foul away. What a cut he had, 0-1.
Well, you got two philosophies here. Eddie Haas went to his bullpen. That didn't work. Dick Williams stayed with his starter, and that didn't work.
The Braves need a fly ball. Fairly good depth because of Horner. He just has average speed. The 0-1, just off the corner inside. One ball, one strike. It's 4-4 with Atlanta. Big opportunity, a runner at third and only one down, and a contact hitter at the plate. Hope he doesn't strike out much. Here's a 1-1 towards second. Problem. Looks home, throws to first. Didn't get it through. Horner couldn't do a thing about it. Flannery chased it down and threw him out.
Ball is fairly sharply hit, but Flannery gets to it okay. Keeps it in front of him. And the underhand toss gets overcut.
Now Cerrone will be lifted for Chris Chambliss.
Cerrone last time up at a base hit and an RBI. 1-for-3 for the night for Rick Cerrone.
Wouldn't you think that just walked Chambliss here and pitched to the right-hand hitter?
Yeah, but I've been wrong. We've been wrong all night.
Yeah, and it's not the first night either, is it?
I thought they'd walk Obergefell. Gotta walk Chambliss to pitch to the righty, I would think.
They're gonna pitch to him.
Yeah. I guess that's why we're up in the booth. There's Dick Williams looking on. San Diego Padres were 5 games in front July 4. 5 games in front on July 4. And there's a foul away. Shows you how fast that lead can evaporate. Today, they're 5 back, and it's not a month. Dodgers, one of the hottest teams in baseball, lead the West now. And the 0-1 pitch. Popped him up. Foul. Royster chasing. He's made a lot of catches down there. And he made another one in a different uniform. The Braves tie it, but they had a chance to go out in front. We go to the ninth, 4-4.
E1 program. So advanced to capture Willie's sheer grace at second base. So much camera to follow Willie all the way home.
Hey, can I try your cannon?
Sure, it's simple.
In sun or shade, it's a snap to use. The Canon AE-1 program. So advanced, it's simple. Canon, the official camera of the Atlanta Braves.
He turned a bunch of prisoners into a team of soldiers. Charlton Heston is Major Dundee at 10:20 Eastern on the Superstation tonight.
We're going to the ninth inning. You can see Bruce Benedict, the new catcher. Bobby Brown is a pinch hitter for Eric Shaw. Brown's a big guy. Batting only 167. No homers and 4 RBIs. Suter with the first pitch. 0-1. Flannery's on deck. Tried to bunt it. Oh, and two. The outfield plays Brown way around. Suter wants a new baseball. Mr. Harris obliges. They're now in the eighth. New York 1, Montreal nothing. White Sox and the Red Sox at Fenway Park, Boston are 4-4 now in the eighth. Suter tried to make him go after a real bad one on an 0-2 count. Tigers walloping Kansas City 10-3 in the sixth. The Orioles and the Blue Jays are 2-2 in the eighth as the Blue Jays go for their 10th win in a row. That's a strikeout for Suter. I don't think Brown has seen that split finger fastball often, and if you haven't, you're in trouble. Flannery is 0-for-4.
Delano Shaft, 8 innings, 6 hits, 4 runs, all earned, 4 bases on balls, 1 intentional, 6 strikeouts, 1 home run.
0-1, Shaw in 8 innings, allowed 6 hits, 4 runs earned, 4 walks, 1 intentional, and 6 strikeouts. So both starting pitchers pitch well here tonight. 1 ball, 1 strike. Two balls and a strike. Giants and the Dodgers play later. Dodgers walloped them yesterday. They had a 7-run inning to do it.
That's well hit. Can Washington cut it off? Yes, he does. And he'll hold him to a long single. Nice play, Claudel. And he gets a hand for it. That ball gets by. Flannery's got a double or a triple.
He hit a good pitch. It was that split finger fastball, and it was down and away. Washington just does get to this ball. And if he doesn't, if he gambles on it and doesn't get it, Flannery is standing at third.
Tony Gwynn has two hits, drives it to right. Washington should catch it, and he does. A couple of balls hit right on the button by Flannery and Gwynn, but a runner at first and two away. Garvey against Suter batting 154 is the next hitter. He's one for four. The Dodgers thought that Garvey might be through a few years back when they let him get away, but he's proven otherwise. Along the line and left, hooking! Foul, luckily for Atlanta. Garvey just missed a double. There have been three balls hit right on the button, the last three batters.
And in the ninth, there were a couple of ropes, or the eighth inning, there were a couple of ropes hit, too. He's not exactly fooling them.
Two outs, a runner at first. Royster's the on-deck hitter. Suter needs one more out here in the top of the ninth. It's 4-4, and the 0-1. Toward third, Obi to second, inning's over. We go to the bottom of the ninth. Braves 4, Padres 4.
Give me a light. Bud Light. If you just ask for a light beer, you never know what you'll get.
Bud Light! Yeah.
So if you want the less filling light beer with the first name and taste, don't just ask for a light beer.
Give me a light.
Ask them to bring out their best. Bud Light. Because everything else is just a light.
I have bugs in my house.
Ding dong, okay, man.
Oh, good, I have bugs.
Don't worry, I'll get them.
Okay, you bugs, the okay, man is coming to get ya. Spray, 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 you can't hide from me.
I'm gone.
Are you sure? I'm the okay, man, aren't I?
Protect what you care about. Call Orkin, America's most trusted pest control.
Thank you, Orkin man. You're welcome.
I'm here about that job.
Hey, Sam, you look like you might be able to get a rig from there to there. But can you get that rig from there to here?
Well, let's see. Well, how'd it do?
Well, you just backed yourself into a job.
The Red Man Reaction. Satisfaction.
There's the goose. You can see the numbers. One of the premier relief pitchers in baseball. Gossage may have lost a little bit off his fastball. Some scouts have said that. Not too much, but some. But he compensates. He'll throw you a pretty good curveball or slider. Outside with the fastball, 1-0. Thompson's on deck. He'll hit for Suter. And the 1-0. Outside. 2-0. Hubbard to batter. He is 1-for-3. Gossage doesn't waste any time. Strike call, 2-1. Straight back, 2-2. There's some more good numbers. And a 2-2. Outside, 3-2. Same two clubs tomorrow night. Air time is 7:35. And the pitch swung on, popped him up. Royster, Gossage hollering. Royster catches it. Now Milt Thompson. Young man, when he's been called upon, has done all right. He's batting .297. He hasn't played much. This is his 17th game. No homers, one RBI. If the Braves don't punch over a run, Jeff Deadman will be the pitcher in the 10th inning. Washington's on deck. What a cut. Look out. Thompson fouling into the Padre dugout. Everybody's okay, I think. That scattered a few. Wants another fastball, which doesn't surprise anybody. 0-2. Thompson hasn't seen that much of Gossage either. That's not an encouraging stat right there. And the 0-2. Breaking ball, base hit. How about that? Milt Thompson got the breaking ball on the face. On the hand, broke his bat, single to left. And he can run. Eddie Haas might turn him loose. Maybe not right now, but later.
Right off the hand, you see the bat shatter. But he got just enough of it to get it over the head of Gary Templeton.
Well, Thompson continues to impress. He's hitting right around 300 with a big lead. He's not going. There's a high pop foul out of play by Claudel. With a pretty good lead. There he goes, and it goes high into the air on the pop. Thompson's being deep. He's got to get back. And he does. The catch is made in short right by Flannery as Templeton put the decoy on Milt Thompson. He didn't know where the ball was, but he finally picked it up and moved back. Two away. Ramirez the batter. Braves got to get Thompson down to second base. They had him going that time. They might do it again right now. Two outs. Murphy's on deck. Gossage might go over there. No, he steps off instead. That's a pretty good way to stop him, too. Now he's ready. There goes Thompson. There's a throw, and he is... stolen base. The winning runs at second.
His third and the third stolen base by the Braves tonight. There haven't been many games where the Braves have swiped that many in 1985. The throw eluded Flannery, but Templeton did his job and backed it up.
So Ramirez for the chance to win it. One ball, one strike. Murphy on deck. Two outs in the pitch. Swung on it, foul, back out of play. A broken bat single and a stolen base. But Atlanta needs a clutch hit. One and two. Here it is. Hit toward left center field, but it's going to be caught by McReynolds going away. Ramirez flies to deep left center. It's 4-4. We go to the 10th.
Now, direct from the future, comes the Canon T70. The T70, sleeker to hold, simpler to handle. Controls are now touch button. Data now crystal clearly displayed. Film advance now built in. The Canon T70. Now you can capture computer-perfect pictures with the touch of a button. The Canon T70. Touch the future now.
We cannot afford to be late. We cannot afford to be anything less than accurate and fair.
Headline news anchor Chuck Roberts.
And I think that's reflected 48 times a day in our shows.
At your convenience.
It's like a sentinel. It's a nightlight. It never goes away.
Headline news around the world every 30 minutes.
It never stops.
All right, we've completed nine. San Diego, 4 runs, 10 hits, no errors. Atlanta, 4 runs, 7 hits, no errors. Jeff Dedman, the new pitcher. Skip Carey is the announcer.
Okay, Ernie, thank you. See Dedman completing his warm-up tosses. He's 4-1, an ERA of 2.93. Well, you see his stats right there. And he has a chance if he can get him out to pick up another victory here this evening. He'll face his old friend Jerry Royster. Lead off the 10th, it'll be Royster, Kennedy, and Martinez against Jeff Dedman, who is the fourth Atlanta pitcher of the night. Suter went an inning and two-thirds, allowed two hits, struck out one, did not walk anyone, no runs. And now Dedman is off. Braves 6-5 in extra inning games. The Padres are 4-7. And Royster ready to stand in there. Jerry just completed or closed the sale of his Atlanta residence earlier today. Now as a full-time resident of San Diego, has purchased a home out there. And he tells us that real estate value, you never realize what a good deal we have in the South until he tried to buy one out in the San Diego area.
On a golf course, too, I suppose.
Wow. But he's batting 280 as Royster. Knuckle curve caught the corner, 0-1. Jerry's first plate appearance tonight. Mark and Laura Lynn Fredrickson celebrate their second anniversary tonight. 0-2, knuckle curve again. Tom Seaver let that lead get away. The Red Sox and White Sox 4-4 after 8 now. Seaver's still the pitcher of record. Royster out of the batter's box. He bounced it up there that time.
Seaver's trying to win .299 in Boston tonight, and if he did, he would try for .300 against the Yankees in New York, right across the road from Shea Stadium, where he spent so many fruitful years.
Wouldn't it be something if that all worked out and his pitching opponent was Phil Niekro going for what, 295 or 296?
No, Nuxie's got 294. He'd be going for 95. He needs six.
The 1-2. Look out. Fastball right over his head. Evens it up 2-2. Just missed with a knuckle curve, low and away. So a pitch of decision is due Jerry Royster. Royster has 5 stolen bases this year in limited playing time, and with that total is second on the Padres. Deadman's payoff pitch. That's out of play. It's still 3-2. Man with a glove made a good play down in the picnic area.
Before he came to the game, the fellow he's with probably said, what are you bringing that glove to the game for?
Catch a foul ball.
Yes. Nothing to it. 20,000 people, and they hit one right to him.
Oberg fell to his left, made a good play on a short hop. One out. Drevecki and Johnson, the pitchers tomorrow night. We'll have it for you at 7:35 Eastern Time right here on WTBS. They smoked him. Fastball over the outside edge at the knees, 0-1. Out, Ossie Virgil. He ripped it foul. Swung late on yet another fastball. It's 0-2. Upstairs, a ball, two strikes.
Got an old-fashioned pitch. You don't see many of those today. 0-2 count, fastball under the chin.
Line foul again down the left side. Still a ball and two strikes on Kennedy. Carmelo Martinez waits on deck. The wind kicking up again here. We could have some showers, though they've avoided us so far tonight. We're in the 10th. A little tap. Tough play, Oberg fell. Kennedy doesn't run well, and he got him by a step. Martinez, 2 out of 3 with a run scored. And 2 driven in. We mentioned it hasn't rained yet tonight, so this is a dry Martinez stepping in.
Give him the other one, too.
I can't tell him. If he falls behind in the count 0-2, he'll be a dry Martinez on the rocks.
Yeah.
And then if he strikes him out with a curveball, he'll be a
twist.
Dry Martinez on the rocks with a twist. But none of that has happened yet. One ball, no strikes.
We rehearse these on radio, and if they go over with Rick Shaw, our engineer over there.
Well, we try them out in the big leagues over
there. Yeah, try them out in Hartford.
That's where I'm going to be if I keep this up. At the knees, 1-1. McReynolds is next.
That's where they used to try out all those plays. Instead of doing it in New York right away, they go to Hartford and test it. Fans liked it. They'd bring it back.
I don't think in theater circles
patrons,
they call them fans,
patrons,
do they?
Patrons. Theater goers.
There we go. Mr. First Nighter. 2-1 to Martinez. Same spot as the first one. Martinez says, no comprendo. 2-2.
Now he might throw one with a twist.
I think he tried out English and said that was awful. He's on the rocks with a twist and the inning is over. Nothing doing in the top of the 10th. We go to the bottom half, all tied at 4. Schedule. scheduled on TBS at this very moment is Major Dundee with Charlton Heston. And we hope that'll be along very soon, as soon as this game is over. If Murphy can unload one. Major Dundee is about a group of prisoners who are turned into a group of soldiers by Charlton Heston. 0-1 to Murphy. I thought that was the Dirty Dozen with Lee Marvin, but what do I know? Gossage to Murphy. There's that curveball Ernie was talking about. He took a little off, and it's 0-2.
He's made the adjustment. Just can't look for the number one from him.
Murphy has, in his career, 0-11 against Gossett. Make it 0-12. Murph throws the bat away in disgust. First strikeout for Gossett. Bob is 1-for-3 tonight with a sacrifice fly and an RBI. Breaking ball, 0-1. Looks like he goes more to his curveball against the guys who with one swing can end it than he does against the singles hitter. Fastball, Royster, good play to his left. Two out. Well, it's all up to Terry Harper. He's homered way back in the second. Since his fly to center, struck out, bounced out, driving in another run. He has 53 on the year.
It was a good play by Royce. You have to remember the third baseman guarding the line against the double had to come a long way, and Royster made a good play, as did Obergfell earlier. He did it in the 10th inning, top half. He made two good plays.
Terry Harper with two out. Curveball, 0-1. Boy, and his control on that breaking ball is outstanding. If you see what I mean, 0-2. He's let it out a notch here in the 10th to this point. Headed for right field, an 0-2 hit for Harper. That is the second surrendered by Gossett, and that's the winning run at first with two out.
He gave him a fastball, but you know where it was. It was on the outside part of the plate that kept Harper from pulling it. And here's Obergfell.
With that mustache, Gossett, if he doesn't have his good stuff, he still scares you to death.
Yeah. I think that's one of the reasons he has it. A lot of relief pitchers like to intimidate the hitter one way or another. Good fastball and a big beard, that or mustache could do it.
One ball, no strikes. But if you just have the beard and the mustache and you throw a 72-mile-an-hour fastball, don't try to...
You're in trouble.
Tap to third. Royster has to wait. He's got a good gun, and the inning is over. We're going to go to the 11th inning. We've played him a lot longer than this. We're tied at 4. We go to the 11th inning. Dedman will face the lower end of the Padre order. McReynolds, Templeton, and Gossage are due up here. A left-hander looks like Craig Leffert's throwing in the bullpen now for the Padres. They may pinch it for Gossage here no matter what. They may pinch it for him only if there are runners aboard. We'll let Dick Williams make that decision. And to tell you all about it, here again, Ernie Johnson.
Thank you, Skip. Dedman working his second inning. You see Lefferts getting ready in their bullpen. It's a 4-4 game. Padres with 10 hits and the Braves with 8. They're now in the 10th inning at Boston. The White Sox and the Red Sox tied at 4. Detroit's hammering Kansas City 10-3 in the 7th. The Yankees still leading Cleveland 1-0 in the fifth inning of the second game. The Yankees won the first 8-5. And they're in the ninth at Baltimore 2-2, the Blue Jays and the Orioles. Texas 3, Milwaukee 1, they're in the sixth. And later, California plays at Oakland.
Dwight Gooden got the shutout again.
2-0, New York over the Expos.
That's 10 straight for him.
Pop foul by McReynolds off to the right. McReynolds is hit by a pitch, struck out, grounded out, and flied to center. Although his average isn't that high, at 236, he's been a productive player with 57 RBIs. He's got some power, the 0-1. Driven all right. Washington to the track, and he's got it. That ball took off on him. Waddell with his speed caught up to it. Gooden had a five-hit shutout today. Gullickson was a loser. Gary Templeton, the batter. Let's give you some of the home runs hit today in the major leagues. McGee hit one for St. Louis. Bounce to third. Obi with another chance. That's his third opportunity, third assist in less than two innings. Cincinnati beat Houston 4-1. Soto beat Ryan. No homers in that game. Carlton Fisk has hit his 27th home run of the year for the White Sox tonight. That's a career high for him. And he's in his late 30s. Al Bumbrey will be on as a pinch hitter for Goose Gossage. Bumbrey played in the American League for many years with the Baltimore Orioles. Salazar's hit a home run for the White Sox tonight. And Wade Boggs is also homer for the Red Sox. Brett a home run for Kansas City in that slugfest. Most of it by Detroit. Two outs. Deadman's pitch. He went around. Winfield and Baylor home runs in the first game for the Yankees. Rick Camp starts throwing for Atlanta. Ricky Henderson is accounted for the only run for the Yankees in the second game for the home run. And an old ex-Brave, Jeff Burrows, hit number 5 tonight, and the first was one aboard. And now Toronto has gone out in front in that ball game. They just got a run in the top of the ninth. They lead Baltimore 3-2, bottom of the ninth coming up. Last chance for the Orioles. Trying for their 10th in a row. Bobby Cox is, he could run for the mayor if they have mayors in Toronto. 4-3, Milwaukee over Texas now in the seventh. McDowell, a home run for Texas.
I don't know if they have a mayor in Toronto or not. I know they have theater fans.
Wow, Gossage. Two innings, two hits, one strikeout.
Here's a 2-1. A little bit high. Gossage pitched a couple of shutout innings. That's nothing new for him. He allowed two hits. 3-1 on Bumbrey. Fouled away. It's a 3-2 count. Looking ahead to the bottom of the 11th. It'll be Benedict Hubbard in the pitcher. And it appears that Lefferts will pitch for them. Deadman with a 3-2 on the way. He struck him out. Foul tip, and Benedict hung on. 4-4. And from the stretch, the pitch is low. Foul up this way, right underneath the booth. 1-1. Scroogey. Hit toward left field, but it's not going to carry. Warning track. Martinez made the catch. Benedict hit it well, but he had Martinez on the warning track for out number one. Hubbard's one for four. Fastball high. Kaminsk, 1-0, outside. Two balls and no strike. Must have been right on the knees, 2-1. Nakahoma's got him yelling a bit. He's on top the Braves dugout. 2-1. Foul away. He came up and Hubbard just missed it. His dad might have been in the service.
How often do you have two guys born in Germany facing one another in a major league game? You got that right now.
That's right. Hubbard was born there too. Balls and two strikes. Fly ball left. Not going to carry. Just about the same spot as Benedict. Hubbard flies deep. Two down. Last year, Lefferts was 3-4 with 10 saves. ERA was a dandy one, 2.13. In fact, in the major leagues, his ERA is 2.59. He came up originally with the Cubs. Kaminsk at 214, looking for his first homer of the year. He has 10 RBI. That first pitch was a screwball. It's the 11th inning, 4-4 and the 0-1. Scrooby is going to be popped towards short right. Gwynn, out number three. Braves go quietly in the 11th. We go to the 12th. It's still 4-4.
Is still viable following the game tonight on WCBS until such time as they call us and tell us any programming changes that might occur.
We go to the top of the order, and Tim Flannery will lead it off against Rick Kemp, the new Atlanta pitcher. If Kemp is to be effective in this game, you'll see a good curveball from him. That's a pitch that he has developed in the last month or so. He's been working on it for about 2 years now. Flannery is 1-for-5. He's singled in the ninth. The fastball is high and outside. 1-ball, no strike. Side edge, it's 2-1. These two teams are even in the season series, three games each. So we got a lot of activity with the Padres yet to go. That's not good news. 3-1. Padres trail the Dodgers by 5 going into the night's play. Hot shot, base hit right center. So the leadoff man is on. Flannery is held at first by Dale Murphy, with nobody out. And now Gwynn, Garvey, and Royster, the three that Rick Kemp has to get. Downstairs, 1-0. We're in the 12th inning. Both teams involved in their 12th extra inning game of the year. The Braves have had the better luck of the two. They're 6-5. The Padres 4-7. There's a strike. Up the middle, yes, base hit. Flannery slips. He's going to try for third anyway, and he will make it. They're on the corners. It looked like Flannery was going to take a hitter out around second base, but he skidded around the bag, maintained his feet, and pedaled on into third and camps in a miss.
Gwynn has his third hit. Looked like Camp might have touched that ball. He came close to it. Runners first and third, and Braves in a heap of trouble.
Here's Garvey. They're on the corners with nobody out. There's that curveball for a strike. Infield halfway for the Braves. Got away with a high fastball, and he's got him 0-2. He wants the strikeout here. The Garve is 1-for-5. Single to lead off the eighth. A bad hop bouncer over Hubbard's head. Got him with a curveball. Boy, there's a big strikeout. And now Jerry Royster, the batter. He bounced to third. His first time, if you followed Braves baseball for a time, first this.
This is a good curve, and Camp has come up with a pretty good curve, a better curve than when the season started. Got to be alive. I think you're going to talk about Royster. He could drop down a bunt anytime.
And we've seen it, and you've seen it if you follow the Braves on numerous occasions. The infield now is going to play Oberkill even with a bag at third. Hubbard is back at second, and Ramirez is cheating a little bit. He's about halfway at short. Corner, of course, holds the runner at first. Royster bounced to third in his only plate appearance. He didn't mean to, but he fouled it off. It's 0-1. A fastball in on it. Padres have out-hit the Braves 12-8, but where it counts, we're knotted at four. There's the curveball, fly ball left field, should be deep enough. Flannery tags, Harper with the catch. Here comes Flannery, here comes the throw, he is safe. Closer play than I thought. Terry uncorked a strong throw. But Royster drove in the run that gives the Padres the lead. Biting the hand that once fed him. The runners will go from first and second on the 3-2 pitch. Kevin McReynolds is on deck. There are two out. The curveball is hit into deep left center, but an easy play for Murphy. Back a few steps, and the inning is over, but the Padres push across the go-ahead run. They do it on two hits. No errors, two left. We go to the bottom half of the 12th. Braves have their backs to the wall. They trail by a run.